Good evening, Internet. This is Victor Burr with The Explosive Truth, and I'm not going to lie, I'm pretty tired, but I need to get this out online. So I'm trying to get out online tonight our first test that we did for the balloon launch. I wanted to show you guys really quickly exactly what the launch looked like. As you see here, this is where we started out near Johnstown, and we launched from my friend's airstrip out here, and we had a very strong jet stream that day, and that thing carried the balloon very far. In total, it was about 86 miles, maybe a little more, as the crow flies, or as the balloon flies in this case. And as you see, it popped. This data can be, we'll make it available at some point here in the near future for download, the actual data itself. As far as the route goes, the balloon popped right around 113,819 feet. So I think that's plus or minus 20 feet is the error that I believe is on that APRS tracker. So as you see, we got a ways out there. I want to apologize for not being able to live stream the main event that we were planning on doing. We launched our second balloon, which was supposed to be our main balloon, and while it wasn't a complete failure, the parachute deployed better than this first one, and we were able to recover it and actually get underneath the balloon, and we got higher. We got up to 116,000, I think 500 and some odd feet. Even though we had success on recovering the main section of the payload, the gimbal tore off with our camera. And so that was really, honestly, a pretty devastating blow, very depressing. We had no footage from it. As far as the live stream goes that we were supposed to do, my mage well conked out on me, and you know, I had that was going to be what was converting. I had SD coming down from my 900 megahertz video receiver, and then that was going into an SD video converted to HDMI. The HDMI was going into the mage well. The mage well was going into a USB converter, and the USB was going in as a webcam. And the whole thing just didn't work in the end. It worked the night before, and then the day of it didn't work. I was just trying to monitor and make sure I knew what the balloon was doing. But I'm sure you guys saw stuff on Rob's channel, Rob Skiba's channel, and Rick Hummer. They came out and joined us, and it was a lot of fun. Main thanks I want to give out there is A to Brandon Myers for funding the main portion of this and being a good friend and helping so much with getting this done, and same thing to Josiah, and also to Bob out in Pennsylvania. You know who you are, Mr. Bob. You've been a great help to us financially and encouraging us to really do this research and get out there and you know, not be biased. That's what we're trying to do. We're just trying to do good experimentation and show what we see. So without further ado, I'm going to let the raw footage play. I have it here. I'm getting ready to export it with this clip at the beginning, and I want it to be as raw as possible for you guys to go through and just let us know what you think about this balloon launch. I have actually a rotation on that. I'm trying to take the FX off of these things. I'm not quite sure which FX I have on this. Maybe it's scale. But in the end, I just want to put this data out there. We're going to do another balloon launch. We have a couple of things that we need to correct. I didn't have enough battery supplied to the gimbal in this first one, in our test launch, and our tether was too short, so it actually severely hindered the parachute from deploying. You can see the gimbal gave out here. We had several jets pass early on. I'm just going to be straight up honest. This footage, while very scientific and rectilinear and in no way fisheye, it's not as interesting as a fisheye. It is interesting to those who are wanting to study this subject of the shape of the Earth, and it's interesting to me because I'm trying to set a world record. I think we honestly have the world record now, right now, for the highest functioning gimbal. We, like I said, we put a gimbal and it functioned up all the way to probably around 80 or 90,000 feet before it finally gave out. Yeah, to me it's interesting. I hope it is to you guys as well. this last shot before the balloon pops, you can see Cleveland, and you can see Lake Erie and part of, I think that's Lake St. Clair right down the corner, and I think that might be Lake Huron right there. So as you see, the balloon pops. 3, 2, 1, pop. Actually, it has a little bit of time left. So you see here in a second, it pops and it envelops the entire payload and parachute, which was our fault because we went with too short a lead. And the second time, honestly, we did have too long a lead on there. We overcompensated and put almost, I think, probably almost 70 feet of lead in total. So next time we're going to strike a happy average, and we have some really good ideas for keeping the whole payload stable and making sure we have enough juice on board. So again, this is Victor Brewer with the Explosive Truth. I'm going to really try to start putting out more updates. Please forgive the lack of updates. And like I said, we're going to put these experiments out there in a much more compiled fashion in the future. But for right now, I just want to get it out there to the public for all you guys to see and enjoy and actually utilize. Thanks and have a good day.
And ready?
Yep.
All right. Thank you. Can you pull the cable, the wires up?
These here?
Yes. Nervous. Right, there's that. Pull it tight. Pull it your way a little bit. All right. Enough for government work. All right, Andy. Take the weight off. Let's start letting it up. Okay. Alright, we're gonna walk out that way.
I know. Ready? Yeah, I'm gonna lift this up, right?
Yep. Okay. Check control. Feels good. Let me turn on this.
Nathan, can you go power up the Inspire and the Phantom really quick? How far you want to go? Nathan, go ahead and fly it up, unless you want to switch me.
Oh, let you go ahead and fly.
Got it?
Okay. Yeah. Alright, Andy. Start letting it out slowly. Don't get yourself rope burn. Should we wait for this dude to pass? I can't see him. Oh, there he is. Yeah. We can let it up a little more. I'm holding this, so. Don't feel the tension. It does feel pretty strong, don't it? Here, hold this for a second, would you? I got this.
Got the balloon?
Yeah, I got the balloon. Wow. Holy cow. Alright, tell me when he's passed. Is he in a spin thing?
No, it's a sus.
Yeah. He ain't turning, do you?
I think we're fine now.
All right.
All right. Ready?
Well, hold on, give me 5 seconds.
All right. Tell me when.
Anytime.
All right, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah, who knows?
And that is